wasn't until the 1970s that racing motorcycles turned to disc brakes. The great advantage of the disc is that it's out in the air and stays much cooler. Even the discs are bigger than they used to be, and at the front, there's one on each side of the wheel. Many different materials have been tried for the discs. Alloy for lightness, cast iron for rigidity, steel for strength. On Honda's championship bike, even carbon fiber for the rear brake. Rear brakes aren't so important, as you can see from their smaller size. The biggest visible difference between today's racing bikes and those of previous times is today, the racing rules still don't allow the front wheel to be covered, or the back half of the rear wheel, but designers still make every effort to reduce drag. And this is important, not just to make your bike as fast as it can be, but also so that you can leave the smallest hole in the air behind you. One of the ways you can get past the other guy is by getting a kind of toe. The front bike punches a hole in the air. This means the air resistance.